In a May 7th news conference, County Executive George Latimer released a report on the agreement negotiated by his predecessor for the company Standard Amusements to operate Playland. The conclusion? The contract needs to be renegotiated or terminated.
We have to look at whether or not the concept of privatizing Playland is about what will better manage the asset or what is in essence a step to devolve the asset out of county ownership. I think it's fair to say that there are individuals, certainly in the last administration without identifying them individually, who have said publicly they didn't believe that we should run an amusement park, we should have an amusement park. And I think the lack of commitment to looking at Playland as an asset is what undermines this overall arrangements. You will negotiate the deal very differently if you see this facility as I do, which is this is the jewel of our park system. This is something unique. When someone says no other government owns or runs an amusement park, I don't consider that a negative. I consider that a positive. This was the wisdom and the vision generations ago to take this piece of land and turn it into something very special. How you approach the value of this asset will determine how you negotiate the arrangements to manage it. And I'm afraid that my general sense of it is that this was viewed as some type of a loss leader, which it is not, and therefore was subject to devolution to a private entity, rather than to find that right balance between public and private interests in the negotiation of this.
The agreement stated that the county is responsible for $33 million in capital investments, plus whatever is necessary for the pool, and Standard is responsible for $27 million, of which $14 million is in ride investment. The agreement also states that Standard does not have to make any investment until the county makes 50% of their capital investments. So, having been involved in some of these public-private partnerships in my prior positions, when the private entity doesn't have skin in the game at the beginning, that's not a great thing.
Is Standard Amusements capable of meeting its obligations under this agreement, and has it met those obligations? And we mentioned the absence of a key person, Mr. Falfus, who was supposed to, who was identified in the agreement as a material person that would run the park. Secondly, if the likely financial impact over this is a 30-year term, a long-term agreement, if the likely financial impact is not beneficial to the taxpayers, can we renegotiate it to make it more equitable and fair? Can we renegotiate the terms? Can we look at the fact that while there seems to be a thought that this was going to be an even split, that Standard Amusements is going to invest the same amount as the county. In fact, there's a provision in that agreement which opens the door for the county to be obligated to spend a lot more, and it's very unclear what that obligation is, and that needs to be revisited. And then finally, if we can't renegotiate what's the cost of terminating the agreement? Is it cheaper for the taxpayers to terminate the agreement than to go forward with a 30-year agreement that will be less advantageous, where the county will lose money, comparatively speaking?
As someone who has had a background in the private sector, where you've looked at contracts, in the public sector, you've looked at contracts here and up in Albany, when you saw this from the inside, what was your reaction, and where would you rank this on a scale of, say, 1 to 10?
Well, if 10 is the best possible contract that you could have, I rank this, in the lower portion of it, 3 or 4. I viewed this, frankly, as I read it, and I didn't necessarily read it with the legal eye that John would put to it, but as a layman, I read the contract, and it felt to me as if this was an effort to rid ourselves of something rather than to have a long-term relationship that would improve the facility. And I read that because I saw very little return back to the people of Westchester County from this, and more an effort to try to put this asset in a private pair of hands.